Hello, my dear students. Very good morning to all. Hope you are all doing good. After a long time, we are meeting in this online platform. I am very happy about that. Today, we are going to see about an important topic, nuclear hazards, which is otherwise known as radioactive pollution or nuclear pollution. Why nuclear hazards is important to study is we are utilizing so many radionuclides in power generation in nuclear power plants. And also as treatment in medicine, and also a source of research for many study purposes. Here you are going to see a video which will describes how radiations are produced and how they are affecting the human beings. The radioactive waste are generated from nuclear power plants and also from medical industry and also from research. The radiation produced are harmless if it is properly utilized, like sterilizing the medical equipments, killing the microbes, molds and insects from the fruits. In fact, the fruits irradiated with gamma rays are having high shelf life, and this is not contamination. The radioisotopes produced are used in surgical tools, X-rays and in radiotherapy. We all know that an atom consists of many particles such as alpha particles, electron, positron, neutron and rays like gamma rays. These gamma rays are utilized in many purposes in radiotherapy. And if it is not properly handled, it will cause contamination by touching, breathing and also ingesting. The radioactive tracers utilized for analysis like CT and the gamma rays mixed up with the water causes severe damage. The radiation produced may be natural or artificial. The radioactive waste generated have several thousand years life, so we must be careful about that. If they are having long half-life, then they will be more harmful, then it is called contamination. If they are having very short half-life, they are less harmful, and that process called irradiation. So, nuclear hazard is nothing but exposure to severe radiations like radioactive nuclides, X-rays, gamma rays, nuclear power plants and nuclear waste. It causes severe danger or risk to the human health and environment. Here you are seeing the animated pictures of nuclear reactor, X-ray picture and gamma ray generation. The nuclear hazards are mainly coming from X-rays, cosmic rays produced in the space and gamma rays. We all know that the nuclear power plants are loaded with nuclear fuels like uranium, thorium and plutonium. They are highly radioactive and they are extremely dangerous. If the nuclear power plants or containers are having leakage, they also persistently emit radioactive radiations. And the nuclear waste generated, which emits strong radiations if not properly stored. What are the causes or sources of nuclear hazards? There are two sources, natural and man-made. Just have a look into the chart. It shows that 85% of the radiations are generated naturally. And only 15% of the radiations are generated artificially or they are man-made. From medicine, 14% of the radiations are produced. And from nuclear industry, only 1% of the radiation is generated. The man-made or the artificial sources are nuclear power plants or nuclear accidents while transporting the radioactive nuclides. Or the radioactive nuclides used in nuclear medicine and mining the radioactive nuclide-rich minerals or ores, and X-rays, medical diagnostic kits, and nuclear bombs are the man-made sources of nuclear hazards. The natural sources are cosmic rays from the space and radon-222 nuclei, soil, rocks, air, water, which are rich in radioactive nuclides. So we know that uranium and thorium are found in soil, and their decay products also produce severe radioactive radiations. K40, that is a potassium-40 nuclide, is present in the human body. Similarly, C14, which is present in all the living organisms. So C14 is utilized in the radiocarbon dating after the death of any animal to find out the age of the animal or human. They are actually continuously created by cosmic rays. Now we are going to see about the control measures of nuclear hazards. After knowing the ill effects and severe damages caused by nuclear hazards, it is our responsibility to control the same. First and foremost thing is, before constructing any new nuclear power plant, we should do risk-benefit analysis and also environmental impact analysis so that the long-term and short-term effects will be known, and we should ensure this power plant should not affect the people and environment nearby. And then the disposal of waste from laboratory should be done carefully once radioisotopes are generated. The disposal of radioactive waste should be done with special attention and utmost care. The workers in the nuclear power plant should be given proper nuclear gadgets and safety measures like radioactive proof clothing and masks so that the radiation cannot penetrate into them. And the leakage of radioactive nuclides from power plants or laboratories should be checked then and there. And the level of radiation pollution monitor should be installed, and the level of radiation emitted should be monitored thoroughly. The explosion of nuclear devices should never be done in the air or in the earth surface. It should be done only underground. Here, the second picture shows the explosion underground, and the first picture shows explosion in the air. So, explosion in the air causes severe damage and it should not be entertained. And in the nuclear reactors, the coolant should be designed in such a way that it is closed with the nuclear core so that the radioactive nuclides cannot escape from the nuclear core. Even though we find many use from radioisotopes, the production of radioisotopes should be minimized. The minimum number of nuclear installations should be done, which means that we should reduce the construction of new nuclear power plants. And the fission reaction should be minimized. Instead of making n number of fission reactions, it should be minimized, because once fission reaction started, it is not possible to stop the emission of radiation by ourselves. And the nuclear medicines or radiation therapy should be applied only when necessary with minimum dosages. If these therapies are not necessary, we will move to some other alternative therapies. The chimneys should be constructed in very height, and ventilation should be given properly so that the radiations or the radioactive radiations gets diluted in the atmosphere. And the disposal methods should be followed with guidelines, and they should be disposed perfectly with the guidelines already given. Now we are going to see about the disposal of radioactive waste or nuclear waste. There are three types of radioactive waste: low level waste, which comprises 90%, intermediate or medium level waste, they are 7%, and high level waste, they are 3%. The low-level waste is slightly contaminated objects like tools and clothings near the power plants. They actually contains 1% of the radioactivity. Similarly, the steel components, filters, and effluents from the reprocessing units containing 4% of the radioactivity are intermediate level waste or medium level waste. And high level waste are spent fuels containing 95% of radioactivity. So based on the levels, the waste should be carefully handled and disposed. The exempt waste or very low level waste, they can be simply incinerated or burned. And the very low level waste, they should be simply landfilled, that is filling in the land and making the radiation to subside. And the low level waste should be packed in concrete silos. And the intermediate or medium level waste should be packed in either in silos or they will be disposed in boreholes, that is deep burials. And similarly, high level waste are given deep geological disposals, that is after making a borehole, we should pack the borehole with the high level waste, or otherwise this waste should be packed in concrete silos and they should be buried deep inside the seas or oceans. Hope you have learnt about nuclear hazards in detail. If you have any doubts, ask me in the chat. Thank you so much. Have a good day.